Hello viewers, I am Rakib. So we have completed our first chapter, which was the fundamentals of Photoshop and an uncategorized lesson, which was creating different shapes in Photoshop. And from this lesson, we are starting chapter 2, that is different selection tools. So there are a lot of selection tools in Photoshop, and we'll start with the Marquee tool, which is here. If you click and hold and select the rectangular marquee tool, if you click, hold and drag like this, you can make a rectangular selection like this with that marquee tool. Let's make a selection here. By making this kind of selection, you can do a lot of things. For example, if you right click here and click and select layer via copy from here and uncheck this background layer, then so you can see we have created a new layer using that selected area from that background layer. Now we can move this layer if we want to use it anywhere else. And as you can see, we have very sharp edges for this selection, and we have some other options for making this kind of selection and copying. And if we delete this and select that marquee tool, rectangular marquee tool again, and if we put the value of this feather to 30 pixel, and then we create our selection again like this, and then you can see we already have the edges softened. And if we press Ctrl C and Ctrl V, we have done the same thing again. Now we have a layer that has soft edges like this. So this is very useful when you want to blend it in the background, like you see, like you can see currently we can use it within this background, and you can't notice any difference in the edges, and it's blended in the background. So this is very helpful when you need this kind of tasks to be done. There are some other reasons why you should make selections. Let's see some other example. If we go to this document, and you can see we have two layers here. One is the front layer, which is layer that has a window, and behind of it is an image that has a moon and sky and a room. Let's say we want to make a selection of this window and want to remove it. For this, we have to select the rectangular marquee tool again and have to set the feather as 0, because we don't want feather right now, we want sharp edges. So we will click here and drag like this, and before pressing the remove from the keyboard, we have to make sure we have selected the correct layer, because currently the window that we want to remove is in this layer 0. So we will select that first, then we will hit delete from our keyboard and press Ctrl D to deselect. Now you can see we have a nice view through this layer, and you can see the layer behind this front layer. So there are a lot of other reasons why you make selections. You will learn them as we go. So this was for the rectangular marquee tool. Let's select the elliptical marquee tool. This one is used for making the elliptical shapes, like if you hold shift from your keyboard and make a circle like this. And we want to copy this moon, so we have to select the layer in which this moon exists. So we have selected that, and if we press Ctrl C and Ctrl V, we select the move tool, and now we can see we have another moon which is in a different layer, which is copied using that elliptical marquee tool. So these are for the different marquee tools, and let's work with the Lasso tool. Let's go to another document which is here. Using this Lasso tool, you can make very quick selection like this, but these are very rough selection. You just want this area roughly and want to work with it later. In that cases, you can use this kind of selection. Here is another tool which is Polygonal Lasso tool, and using this tool you can make polygonal selections like this. You have to click every points like this. If anytime you go wrong, then you press backspace on your keyboard and that will allow you to go backward. Control C, Control V. Now you can see we have selected that polygonal shape like this. There is another Lasso tool which is the magnetic Lasso tool. Using this tool you can make a selection of any object, like if you click here and go from the edges, it will bind to the edges of that object and background. You can make selection like this. It works as a magnet to bind the edges. And whenever you think something went wrong, you will press backspace again. And you can also define any point by clicking like this. And whenever you are at the start point, you'll click and that will make a selection for you. So let's right click and make a copy. So now we have that selected part as a new layer. So in this way you can use this marquee tools and the Lasso tools, but this kind of tools are not use that much in Photoshop. In the next lesson we will learn quick selection tool and the magic wand tool. Those are used more often. So hope to see you guys in the next lesson. Thanks for watching.